everyone. We are team one. I'm Bonnie.
I'm Betty.
I'm Hannah.
I'm Cindy.
I'm Jennifer.
Today here we are presenting you
the Familiar Outlander.
This is the table of the content. Introduction, methodology, results and discussion, conclusion and reference.
Hey, you know, international migrant workers are around our daily life, but do you know how they live in Taiwan?
I have no idea.
It's okay, let's tell you guys. First, I would like to introduce the background and motivation of the research. In recent years, as Taiwan gradually has been developing into the aging society, the workforce of the working class has been shrunk year by year, and the workforce in a variety of industries is understaffed. As a result, it is necessary to hire international migrant workers from Southeast Asia to make up for the shortage of manpower.
However, till now, international migrant workers are the largest group of international workers coming to Taiwan. Therefore, they can be commonly seen in our daily lives. Purpose. However, due to differences in many ways, every year, Indonesian migrant workers file more than 10,000 complaints to Ministry of Labor. Therefore, it is needed to know what difficulties they have encountered in Taiwan.
Research questions. Here are research questions. Question 1. What kind of perspective on living and working in Taiwan do the Indonesian migrant workers hold? Question 2. What kind of the difficulty do the Indonesian migrant worker encounter while working and living in Taiwan? Question 3. What are the cultural differences between Indonesian and the Taiwanese in the viewpoint of the Indonesian migrant workers?
Second, methodology. I would like to introduce how to conduct the research. In order to explore Indonesian migrant workers' difficulty, I would like to adopt a qualitative approach by conducting individual interviews. And we also analyze the data. And these are our participants. There are 8 participants in the study, 4 males and 4 females Indonesian migrant workers along with their general background information.
Let's move on to the next chapter, results and discussion. As you can see, Taiwan and Indonesia have a lot of differences such as belief, religion activities, food culture, weather and language. First, because Taiwanese believe in Buddhism and Taoism, and most of Indonesians believe in Islam, the most common religion practices in Taiwan are burning incense stick, burning jewels, paper money, and so on. And Taiwanese hold incense stick in hand when praying to God. In contrast, Muslims should worship 9 times a day in the direction of Mecca's Kaaba without any image of God. As a result, the participants are difficult for Muslims to worship in Taiwan.
Second, as for the food culture, it isn't particularly rigid in Taiwan, but in Indonesia, Muslims don't eat pork-related products. They eat halal food. For this reason, there are fewer food choices in Taiwan for Muslims.
Moreover, Muslims usually eat with their hands in Indonesia. However, Taiwanese almost use chopsticks. As a result, the participants needed to learn how to use chopsticks and get used to using them slowly in order to make their life in Taiwan better and convenient. Third, in Indonesia, there are only summer and monsoon, and Indonesia's rainy season is even more sultry than Taiwan. But in Taiwan, there are 4 seasons in a year. Indonesia participants spend a period of time getting used to the climate in Taiwan. They feel the cool weather in Taiwan was great and comfortable.
Fourth, Taiwanese and Indonesian may have some trouble in communication due to non-English language systems. However, in order to working and living in Taiwan, all the participants have to learn Chinese. They need to get used to the working environment and society by watching Chinese channels, listening Taiwanese talk, speaking with Taiwanese, or relying on other media and agencies and so on. Furthermore, most of the participants were satisfied with the working environment and the wage. They feel that their working hours were flexible. Taiwanese and the EU also treated the participants very well and united among their needs.
Conclusion. Generally speaking, all of the participants did not have much negative thoughts and negative thoughts about Taiwan. Life differences and various adjustments could also be solved by themselves over time. What more, the following are what
using prejudice against Indonesian migrant workers. Second, creating a foreigner-friendly working environment. For example, there should be Indonesian translation on a menu in a restaurant and important signs. Third, we should get to know or to be Indonesian background better and allow us to eliminate the bias against them.
Next, from the standpoint of the government, if the government formulates more policies, such as government subsidies, advocacy, and benefits, first, the government subsidies change the economic situation of their own family. Second, the government advocacy allows us to have a better understanding of Indonesia and to elevate the stereotypes of them. Third, the government benefits cultivate their own professional skills. Finally, these are our references.
Thank you for your attention.
First one to ask you some questions, okay? I would say that very wonderful presentation. You know, from the very beginning of your presentation, let me see, all of you are full of energy, okay? Which is very good, and you cooperated each other, you know, very well. My question is number one, okay? I could see that you are dealing with a very important, you know, issue here in Taiwan. You know, with the diversified population, you would like to know more about this outlanders. But my first question is that, would you please explain to me your motivation? Is there any personal motivation, or is there any, okay, reason that push you to do this kind of project?
老师，你可以再继续。
Okay, thank you. Sometimes when you try to do projects like this, you will have your own position here in this project. You sense that there's something very important that you want to, you know, explore it. And it's because of some driving force, okay, behind this, okay? But I would say that which is very good, okay? Number two, I know that there are four aspects that you dealt with, okay, this issue. Something about culture and language and working or something. Is there anything which is so special that, you know, deepen your impression about this outlander situation? Because there are so many participants that you have interviewed, right? Or you have done, you know, questionnaires with. So you are quite good. I see that you did a lot of statistics. But is there any special thing that made you, okay, you know, impressive during this process of making out or working out this project? Is there anything, you know, very special after, or what touched you, okay, after doing this project? Thank you. You are good. Don't be nervous. You are very good.
自己的练习。
你们讲讲看，你们在做这个过程当中有没有什么？因为这是一个很大的意识，也很重要。那你们有这么多的印尼的人士来参加我们这边的问卷，那你们有什么在做完之后有什么特别的感受或特别的想法？谢谢，
很棒哦，加油。
We think that the most difference is about their maybe is their appearance or any custom is different from us, and the weather or the language is the most difference. Yeah, the most different from us.
Yeah, good enough. Yeah, good.
Well, thank you very much for your presentation. As Professor Chen mentioned, it is an important topic, and the topic has its importance to Taiwanese society as well as to the Indonesian migrant workers. My question is, I think it's important to present the insights from the Indonesian workers in Taiwan, but I guess because of the presentation time limit, we haven't really heard their insights more in depth. So you may want to spend maybe a couple of minutes to explain what you found from those Indonesian workers you interviewed. And my second question is that from your interviews, from your research method, you interviewed 8 Indonesian workers. Do you think those 8 interviewees was representative enough for the Indonesian population in Taiwan? Thank you. In the beginning, we interviewed about 16 people, but because of the time is not enough to that we make the research. So finally, we just select about 8 people. Because someone's Indonesian migrant workers answer is not similar our question, so we only select 8 people.
Well done. I can tell that you're very well prepared and you're very confident, which is good. But however, you're being too fluent, that means you're speaking too fast. And you're changing the slides. Yeah, it's just too fast. I cannot even understand the questions when you switch the slides. So maybe you want to take a deep breath and slow down and trust yourself that you'll do a lot better. Okay? Good job.
前面三组的同学是不是要先离开？是，我想这时候我们评审就是给一些意见哈。那这些同学你们很棒，就不要太紧张。第一点，我想就从题目上面，你们的题目是这些 Islanders 的文化差异与各种问题。那我觉得说一个专题的题目，也因为你看今天的报告时间也只有。 8分钟哈。那这个专题是跟着你们整个学期的，那我还是觉得题目可以缩小，比如说缩小在一个负责或是 healthcare 或是等等，这是第一个题目。第二的话，怎么样去把你的专题里面拉进自己的部分？因为每个做专题的孩子，你都是在这个里面，你有自己的位置，是一个高中生的位置，所以我会认为说，第一个可以丰富的是。可以去访问，用 interview 的方式，让你可能只有八个或16个这样的 participants， OK， 让他的那个就是你的内容上面会更深化。好，然后再来的话，我希望你们可以在你的专题里面加上一个东西，就是加上你自己的角色，你的 position， 也就是说，因为我们是做英文的，所以我们可以开始做一些学习单来教印尼人。好，他们哎，比如说，你知道我们台湾的食物是哪些哪些哪些吗？就教他们，那这样你会变成一个在你的专题位置里面，它不是一个 survey 或是一个 statistic 的呈现而已。你们开始会进入到这里来帮助印尼外 outsiders 解决他们台湾的生活，所以给他们一点教育，用英文。好，很好，谢谢，
谢谢。